Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Anaconda, that is Anaconda version 2024.06 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World project on both Jupyter Notebook and Spyder IDE. So now, this video is going to be a bit long and it's going to be informative. So I request you do watch the video till the end. If there's any issues in middle, you can always ask me on this comment sections, along with you can also ask me on Instagram. So I'm going to put all the links in the description. You can also follow me on our Instagram and you can ask all the questions. I'll definitely try to help you. So now, without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install Anaconda, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here, Anaconda download. And hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.anaconda.com as your first search result. So to click on this download Anaconda distribution, so that's going to redirect to the official site of Anaconda. So this link, anaconda.com/download link, I'm going to provide right in your description. So once you are here, you need to just simply scroll down and then you'll see this section over here. So here you can always register, you can provide your email ID, you can check this and click on submit. And you need to confirm your email ID and you can download the product right from there, or else you can just simply skip the registration. You can click on this skip registration and that going to also show you this download button over here. So if you click on this download button, you can see that our Anaconda is rightly started downloading, right? And it is 912 MB file. So now I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory. And here you can see that my Anaconda is already been downloaded over here and the file size is 912 MB as I said. So to install, just simply double click on the exe and our setup is rightly started launching. So welcome to Anaconda setup wizard. Let's first minimize our download directory and here let's just simply click on next. So these are all terms and conditions. You can always read this license agreement and then you can click on I agree. So here under installation type, it has given couple of radio buttons. So whether you'd like to install just for you or for all users. So now I recommend you to install it for all users and click on next. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go. So now this is our installation location. So on our C directory within program data, it's going to create Anaconda 3 as a new folder and then it's going to install all files over there. So you can see that available space is 113.3 GB and space required is 5 GB. So 5 GB of space is going to be required by Anaconda to get installed. And now everything is fine. You need to just check this whether you have this much amount of free space and then you need to click on next. So here it is telling whether you'd like to create a desktop shortcut. Yes, I want to create a desktop shortcut. So I check this. Next thing is it is telling whether you'd like to register Anaconda 3 as a system Python 3.12. So as you know that I have already previously installed Python, so you know I'd like to uncheck this because I have already Python installed, so I don't want to, you know, proceed with this option. If you haven't installed Python previously, then you can always select this and you can proceed with that. It's going to automatically register your Python with Anaconda, so it's going to do everything for you. But if you have installed Python previously and also you are a user of PyCharm and other, you know, softwares, then you can uncheck this and you can proceed. So just I'll uncheck this and click on install and you can see that it is rightly started, you know, installing. You can see it is extracting and it is rightly started installing. So again, it's going to take some time, about 10-15 minutes maybe, you know. So let's wait for some time and after that I'm going to again come back to this video. Yep. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Anaconda is rightly installed. So you can see everything is completed now. So you can just simply click on next. So again, click on next. So both our this launch Anaconda Navigator along with get started with Anaconda distribution options are rightly selected. Just simply click on finish and there you go. So it will first show you. So it will first redirect to browser and it's going to show you some tutorials. You can always read this. Click on get started and you can read all different tutorials that are available over here. Let's, you know, minimize this. I'll proceed with the video. So I'll first recommend you to restart your system. So just simply go to start and restart your system. And after that, let's come back to this video again. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to the desktop. So just simply click on search and type Anaconda over here. So our Anaconda Navigator you'll see over here under apps. So just, you know, simply click on that. So you can see that our Anaconda is rightly started launching. And it has rightly launched. So yeah, it is telling whether it like to update Anaconda Navigator. So for now, just, you know, click on no, remind me later, and let's maximize our Anaconda Navigator. So this is the interface of our Anaconda Navigator, and here you'll see lot of, you know, applications available like Jupyter Lab, Jupyter Notebook, PyCharm Community, Qt Console, Spyder, you know, all these different things. You know, on my previous videos, I have talked about how to install RStudio, then PyCharm Community, and all that. I have already made a detailed video, so you can watch those videos as well if you want. For now, I'm going to talk about Notebook and Spyder. So first, I'll start with Notebook. So I'll just simply click on Launch, and it's going to start launching our Jupyter Notebook. So it is launching our Jupyter Notebook on our browser, and it has rightly launched. So, you know, let's click on this new and click on Notebook to create one new notebook over here. So on our new tab, it's going to create one untitled notebook. So here you need to select your kernel. So I'm going to select Python 3 kernel over here. So just simply click on select. So you can see it is selected Python 3 kernel. You can always, you know, close this Anaconda Assistant for the time being. And here you can write your code. So let's type something like print hello. And I'm going to just simply click on this run button. And you can see the hello output is properly coming on our console. Similarly, you can, you know, start writing all your code over here. You can always click on this, you know, add shell. So that's going to create one more shell. And you can start writing your Python projects. You can write machine learning code. Everything you can do over here. Right. So let's quickly jump over to Spyder. So let's back to Anaconda Navigator, and here you need to click on this launch for Spyder, and it's going to start launching your Spyder IDE. You can see Spyder IDE version 5 is started initializing, and it has rightly launched. So now you can see this is the welcome note. You can, you know, click on start tool, and you can see all the things that it is showing. For now, I'll close this. And I'll close all the thing, and this is the interface of our Spyder. So here they have given already one temp.py file. You can create a new file from here, and you can give your file name, like now it is untitled. You can save this, and you can start writing all your code. So let's write something like print hello. You can see it is already giving all suggestions as I type, you know. So just go to file, click on save as, and save this file on our desktop as main.py. Alright, so file is rightly saved. Click on the run button and keep everything default. Click on run, and there you go. You can see the output properly coming on our console. Right, similarly you can, you know, write all your Python codes over here, and you can start working on, you know, your AI machine learning projects on Spyder. Right, so that's basically all about this video. That's how you install Anaconda and use Anaconda Navigator to launch Jupyter Notebook, Spyder, and all that. You can also launch, you know, PyCharm Community from here. I have also showed you how you can install PyCharm, then RStudio on my previous videos. You can also watch all those videos on our channel. Along with, you can also subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here also regularly I am posting lot of coding related videos, so please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script blogging channel. So I am traveling, I am making lot of videos, so you can, you know, follow Geeky Script blogging channel as well. And also don't forget to follow our Instagram account, so you can ask all your questions over there. I'll definitely going to try to help you. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.